happening again. Mr. Weidman, we're working on lesson 2.2, powers of 10 and the zero exponent. All right, so what I want you to do to start off, I want you to choose a number between 1 and 10, all right, as the base of a power, all right, and I want you to put that right here, all right, so a lot of people are going to have different numbers, and I want you to put that number in there, and then you're going to use this as the exponent, all right. You're going to do the repeated multiplication, and then you're going to solve for it. You're going to put that in standard form, all right? Then you're going to use the same base and each exponent as you go down, all right? And then you're going to do repeated multiplication. So you might want to press pause and do that and see what you get for the last one when this is, zero. Try that out. I also want you to describe any patterns that you see. Now, continue the pattern to complete the entries in the last row, and you see that. Now, what do you think the zero exponent law is? Well, any base raised to the zero exponent will equal 1. Every single time. So x to the 0 equals 1 every single time. I could say, hey, I'm going to give you $1,000,000,000,000,000 to the exponent of 0. You would still only get a dollar. All right, now, can you see similar patterns when looking at powers of 10? Well, let's check it out. 10 to the 9 is 1 billion, and in standard form, that means we've got 9 zeros. Then we've got 100 million, which is 10 to the 8, and if you look at that, we've got 8 zeros. We take away one exponent there, we've got 10 to the 7, then we've got 10 million, then 1 million, then 100,000, 10 to the 4 is 10,000, it's got 10 zeros, 10 to the 3 is 1,000, and 10 to the 2 is 100, 10 to the 1 is 10. Well, 10 to the 0 is 1, if we follow that pattern, and now we have 1. It's like we're having 0 zeros. Alright, let's go down. And this is going to be a quick lesson today. So let's evaluate the following. 4 to the exponent of 0 is just 1. Anything to the exponent of 0 is just 1. Now, we've got this negative out there. It's a little tricky, all right? So we've got 4 to the exponent of 0, which is just 1, and we've got that negative out front. So it's going to be negative 1. Now, when we have a negative in brackets, that means this whole thing is going to be affected by our exponent to 0. And again, we have 1, not negative 1, but just 1. All right? Next, we're going to move on to place value chart and powers of 10 so that we can write any number. All right? So let's start with 3,452, and we're going to use powers of 10 to figure out what it actually is. So we've got 3 thousands, we've got 4 100s, we've got 5 10s, and we've got 2 1s, all right? And we're going to add all these together to get 3,452. Now, this is just like saying 3 times 1,000 plus 4 times 100 plus 5 times 10 plus 2 times 1. Well, how do we write that as powers of 10? Well, Austin Powers. We've got 3 times 10 to the 3. And you'll notice we have 3 zeros. And that's where we get that exponent from. Next we have plus 4 times 10 to the 2. And we have 2 zeros in 100. Then we go plus 5 times 10 to the 1, which is just 10. And then finally, plus 2 times 10 to the 0. All right, because 1 doesn't have any zeros, so it's got 0 zeros. Now, I'd like you to try the following using powers of 10. Give those a shot. The most important idea of this lesson is that any base to the power of 10, to the power of 0, equals 1 every single time. So x to the exponent of 0 equals 1. All right, have a good day. It was a nice short and sweet.